मैडम,
मॉर्निंग मैडम, दिस इज सिद्धार्थ राजगोपाल। वी बीन इन टच विद योर ऑफिस। थैंक यू फॉर स्पेंडिंग टाइम टुडे।
थैंक यू सो मच। एंड लॉन्ग इयर्स बैक आई वाज इन कॉमर्स, तब वी आई यूज्ड टू गिव एमडीआई टू लॉट ऑफ एक्सपोर्ट प्रमोशन काउंसिल्स। दैट वाज लॉन्ग बैक इन 98। तो आप लोगों के साथ कभी मिले होंगे।
यस मैम,
नाइस टू वेलकम यू हियर।
एंड अ
Keep waiting
वेरी
for the
गुड
secretary to
इवनिंग
come
टू
in,
मैम
ma'am.
एंड
Can we?
we are very glad that on a very very fast Ministry of Textile has taken this opportunity for us to talk to you all. And I'll really thank Ravi and his team and calling all of you, and at a very fast, just one letter, and he has called it.
It's an important matter, madam, looking at alternate routes of supplies to Bangladesh, which is an important partner, trading partner for textiles, we see.
Yeah. I was going
Good
through
morning,
the
madam. This is Jaikaran Singh, Trade Advisor from Ministry of Textile.
numbers. Good morning. Is secretary joining?
Yes, madam. It's coming online.
Madam, I'm here very much here. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good
कैसे
morning.
हो? ठीक?
Morning, sir.
क्या हाल है?
Very
Good
much.
morning, sir. Good morning.
क्या हाल है? आपका क्या चाल है?
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Kapoor sir. Good morning, sir.
Morning, morning.
Sir, with you and your madam's permission, shall we start, sir?
Yes.
Morning, sir.
Yes, please. Yes.
One minute, sir.
So we
Before
will
starting,
begin, sir.
Thank on behalf of textile industry, our respected secretary,
Yes, sir.
For the
All are requested to please mute your mic. All are requested to please
Kindly
mute your
mute your
mic.
mics. I will. This is Siddharth Rajgopal. I will start the proceeding. The secretary and the chairperson are
Rajgopal.
here.
One minute, Rajgopal.
Okay, sir.
I just want to thank our respected secretary for giving this overall export today and our sampling also. Sir, thank you very much, sir, for on behalf of our apparel industry. Thank you, sir. Okay,
Thank you very
please
much,
start,
sir.
Rajgopal.
Sir, with your permission and madam's permission, we'll begin, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, everybody, for and good morning for joining in today's webinar on a very important subject of enhancing connectivity within the South Asian region, and especially our trade with Bangladesh through what is now developing, fast developing inland waterway transport corridor. And the Secretary of Textiles, Sri Ravi Kapoorji, and Madam Amita Prasad, and Sri Jindal, Commissioner Customs in the Eastern, have joined in, and we are grateful to them for having spare time today. So we will begin with a small welcome address by Chairman TechPersons, Dr. K.V. Srinivasan. Sir, may I request you to give your welcome address, sir? Thank you. Mr. Srinivasan, unmute, sir, and then speak.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you all at this webinar on the Inland Waterway Transport Corridor for Textile Exports to Bangladesh, being jointly organized by TechPersons and the Inland Waterways Authority of India under the guidance of the Ministry of Textiles, Government of India. We are grateful to Sri Ravi Kapoorji, Secretary, Ministry of Textiles, for taking the time out of his busy schedule today to be with us in these difficult times. He has been the motivating force behind today's webinar, and we welcome you, sir, to this. Fortunate to have the presence of Dr. Amita Prasad, Chairperson of Inland Waterways Authority of India, at today's webinar. We welcome you to the webinar, madam, and look forward to hearing from you about the exceptional work being undertaken by the IWAI in developing alternative modes of transport, especially the waterways. I would also like to extend a warm welcome to Sri Rajesh Jindal, Commissioner of Customs Preventive at Kolkata, West Bengal, who has been proactively interacting with the trade and industry in finding solutions to logistic issues in this region. I would also like to extend a warm welcome to Sri Rajesh Jindal, Commissioner of Customs Preventive at Kolkata, West Bengal, who has been interacting with the trade and industry. Friends, also amongst us today is Sri Sashi Bhushan Shukla, Member, Traffic and Logistics at the Inland Waterways Authority of India, who will make a presentation titled "Development of National Waterways Transport for Indo-Bangla Trade." Welcome to the webinar, Mr.
Chairman,
Shukla. I would also like to extend a warm welcome to the chairmen of various export promotion councils and the chairman of FIEO. Today's topic, friends, is very timely as we face many challenges when trading with neighboring Bangladesh by land route. The slow growth in official bilateral trade could, amongst others, be accorded to infrastructural and logistical constraints. This developing alternate routes of transport, including multimodal transportation systems, thus becomes the need of the hour. I'm sure many of our colleagues participating in today's webinar are actively trading with Bangladesh and are eager to know how integration of inland waterways transport with the present road and rail networks will help us to improve logistic efficiencies across the borders with Bangladesh. Today, which remains an important trading partner for India, especially in the textiles and apparel sector. Bangladesh is our bilateral trade with Bangladesh was worth about US $10 billion in 2019. When we talk about the transportation of goods to Bangladesh, the first thing that comes to our mind is the road route, which is very quick and if there are no delays and disruptions. Other modes of transport like railways are also works in progress. However, another mode of transport which for various reasons has been missed inclusion in our logistic plans is the inland waterways transport IWT system. As we understand, the IWT system is not only fuel efficient, it is also environmentally friendly and cost effective, but it also has the potential to ease the pressure on existing road and rail networks. I am sure our expert panelists in today's webinar will be able to shed light on the IWT system. We would then be able to develop more efficiencies in the textile transportation systems across the border between two major textile manufacturing countries in South Asia. While discussing with a few of our friends in industry who are already having substantial trade with Bangladesh, various challenges which have come up and which could probably be linked to IWT have been highlighted. Some of these are lack of infrastructure needed to support the traded volumes, longer transit time compared to shipments by road and sea, and limitations posed by natural environment like shallow waters, placing restrictions on the amount of cargo that can be loaded onto the transport vessel. We may agree that it's quite impossible to find an ideal solution for cross-border trade. Hence, all stakeholders need to come together and to collaborate to find the best and most cost-effective idea for integrating the IWT system with other means of transportation which are available in the industry. Towards this end, I think today's webinar is very timely, very appropriate, and we are fortunate to have with us the government as well as the implementing authorities on the one hand and the user industry on the other to create awareness and develop the entire ecosystem. Once again, I extend a warm welcome and thank you all for participating in today's webinar. Thank you.
Waterways Authority of India to give our introductory remarks. Madam, please.
Yeah. Good morning, Sri Ravi Kapoor, Secretary Textile, Chairman of Texosil, and all the members who have come here. My own team, member traffic and logistics, Sri Shashi Shukla, Customs Commissioner from Kolkata, and all others who are participating in this webinar. Let me first thank Secretary Textile for responding so fast for this webinar. We had written to him about just a week back, and I was pleasantly surprised that within 3 days' time, Ravi could organize this and look into this timely intervention which IWT has to offer. Shashi Shukla has a presentation which he will be making afterwards. I'll be just giving some of the points which we can look. One thing is that you, the president, in his remarks, he has talked about what are the problems we face. We face certain problems of least, that LAD, what they call it, the least assured depth, which may be problematic between Varanasi and Sahabganj. But beyond Sahabganj, up to Kolkata, Halki, and all other places, we have no problem of, the depth in this. Second thing is about certain point of nature which comes into force, but then that can be taken care of. We have a lot of good systems now, and we have many places from where you can you can upload your things. We have certain pilot movements we can do just to see what type of shortcomings or what type of roadblocks we may face. So from IWI, we are very hopeful that this partnership can work, and we can forge a lasting solution to this. All of you will be very happy to know that recently we, because of this LCS and the road car a jam near Tetrapur and Benapol, we shifted some of the cargo from there towards a jetty. And I must thank Kolkata Commissioner Customs for helping us out on that. So a lot of iron, steel were moved, and then we also moved some other items which are not traditionally being sent here by this. So there is a scope. Of course, we are talking about less carbon footprints. That is there. We are also talking about you know, like a lesser cost. If you compare, it is almost half with the railways and one third of the truck. But then there is a problem, and I must confess to that, that sometimes there may be slightly time more taken. I am offering that we can have at least two pilot movement to look into all the issues. So our ships will help you in taking the first two cargoes. Have a look at it, how it goes, where are we able to do it, and what type of other infrastructure you will like. Shashi will show you where are the port of calls we have, how, which are the routes we can take, and how best we can do. I was going through the figures, and President also mentioned about the figure in his speech. We have a very good share from Bangladesh textile, and I had recently visited Dhaka and realized that there is a tremendous scope of textile, you know, finished goods, as well as a lot of our own Indian companies are there who are operating from Dhaka. So with everybody's you know, cooperation, these things can work. Recently, Calcutta Port Trust also ran a you know, like a pilot this thing from Chatgaon, and they are taking the cargo from Chatgaon to, which is a port, via road to northeast. That is available on Indo-Bangladesh protocol route. Why I'm telling this is not water, but why I'm telling this, finally the three things are in our favor. One, the eastern grid, which is NW1, which is, you call it, from Varanasi to Haldia. Second thing is that this Indo-Bangladesh protocol route. And third one is the NW2, which is Brahmaputra to where we do Dibrugarh. Now all these can be linked up. From Calcutta, we go to Dhaka, and from Dhaka, we move up to Pandu. Now, this is one poor area. I know this consumption is less. Even the, you know, sourcing is less. Sometimes the ships have to go and come back empty-handed. But this route will also give you an entry into Bhutan market, because this is also linked up, and we have under Indo-Bhutan treaty, Pandu, which is in Assam, that is also linked up. So opportunities are there. The waterways are there. In this area, we do not have a problem of lag. This depth problem is not there in this route, except for some issues in upper part of Bangladesh. We are also trying to you know, remove them by dredging and other things, which is going on. So my request to all of you will be that use the route. Unless we use it, we do not know what are the problems and what are the advantages. IFWI is fully geared towards it. In fact, I'm very happy that a new type of cargo has come towards us. You'll be happy to know that we have run about 18 pilot projects in last 2 years on these routes, which I just mentioned. And I'm sure that with your cooperation, this commodity will be also added. My other point and PowerPoint presentation and other things will be talked about by my member traffic and logistics, and all other questions which you like to ask us, please feel free to ask us. Pilot movement we can always do, and we can further work out on this. Thank you very much once again for responding to our request and organizing this webinar. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your observation, madam. I think it's very encouraging, and people will look forward to moving there into this inland waterways. Now, may I request our secretary, sir, to kindly give his address, sir. Secretary, sir.
Chairperson of the Indian Waterways Authority, Madam Sir. My friends from the various councils, I see a lot of people from the various textile councils. My CMD of Cotton Corporation of India, member of the IWI. Let me first compliment the IWAI chairperson for having taken this lead. You know, I have been a big, I come from the Assam cadre, and I have been a very, very big votary of the movement of goods by the waterways from Assam into Bangladesh and beyond, Chittagong Port. And the moment I saw the letter of Madam Prasad, I thought this was a very good opportunity. And since I have been flooded by text profile and others about the huge problems at Petrapol and Binapol, about the total choking of these routes, I thought it would be perhaps a good idea to have a dialogue, open a dialogue at least, with the IWAI and of course the entire industry. Because as pointed out by the chairman text profile, IWAI or whatever it is not on the radar of the movement of goods. Let's accept this fact, that by and large it is not on the radar of the industry. And I would wish that this should be brought not only radar, I would wish that it becomes an integral part of movement of goods from India to Bangladesh. We have huge movement of goods from India to Bangladesh. We are also in the process of signing an MOU with the Bangladesh government on textiles. We are also contemplating of sending cotton, maybe we were talking about rakes through the rail. We can also think about sending bulk cotton to Bangladesh, because Bangladesh is a bulk user of cotton from our side. And we export cotton, we export a lot of yarn. So the yarn people and the cotton people are here. And I'm sure they will take this opportunity to initiate the, I'm not saying, let's initiate the dialogue. I would strongly suggest to Madam Aapko, I very strongly suggest that you give one model person, because it should not be that the industry, I have evoked the industry, interest of the industry. And it should be a very responsive system within AWI who can guide, help, walk through the whole process. Because industry will pick up, it only work where they are comfortable with. If they approach IWI and there is a response system which is very nicely, good response system, I'm sure we can have not just this meeting, not just this seminar, we can create a small platform, a small committee with at least textile people and IWI people to see that what are the issues, what can be shifted, what can be transported, which are the ports which can be used, what is the volume of transport which can come in into this play. I see as a lot of players, you know, a lot of finished goods from here also go. The Mr. Rahul Mehta, I see the chairman of the apparel CMAI. Now, for example, a lot of finished products are being sold in Bangladesh. A lot of brands are going in. They are also trying to get the brands the permission to open up their stores in Bangladesh. Like Biba and all these people are willing to open up their stores in Bangladesh, and the goods will move from North India. So it is very, very much possible that these goods can move on the river route to the waterways and straight into Bangladesh. Having said that, I see a good attendance today in this meeting. I am sure that the presentation made by the member of IWI makes it very clear, without complicating things, in simple words, if my cotton yarn has to move from India to Bangladesh, where can I load, what are the facilities, how much movement can be done, what is the time taken, what is the cost involved in that, what are the, let's identify the bottleneck. I'm not saying that everything will be hunky-dory. I totally understand what you're saying. It will be, initially we can run some pilots, we can see what are the problems, and I think TextProcel should take lead in this. You know, you should take the lead, TextProcel should take the lead. And also, CCI should also look at, I have been telling the last previous MD, I was telling that you should talk about, I'm sure you are engaging with some people for bulk selling of cotton to Bangladesh. Can we move this cotton to the river route? You know, at least, you know, from the northern stores, you can move from Punjab, Haryana, this type, wherever the northern woods are there, you can move this to the river route. Explore that. We are in the exploratory mode at the moment. But as I said, it's not a webinar which is for the purpose of thinking that we have done it. I'm very serious about this, and I let the industry be known about this, that I'm very serious in this matter. And we have a very dynamic chairperson. We should take the advantage of this. We should move into this space quickly. Maybe after today's meeting, a small group of three, four people from TechCoSIL, from CMI and CCI, three, four people, and one or two people from the IWI can come together as a textile group for IWI. And this textile group can then work closely, talk, interact, see what the problems are, what is feasible, and maybe in a month's time from today, you know, I would like a very clear report. And we will meet once again after 1 month, where this homework is done by all the organizations, the field organizations, and give us a realistic picture, don't pose a very rosy picture that this will happen. What is possible? What are the volumes you are looking at? If you do this, what are the problems which we envisage? How do we overcome those issues? I think a very comprehensive report, I don't want a written report. Written report can be given. You share your experiences and come back within a one month's time. And I, Rajgopal, and I would request you that today is 22nd of July. On 23rd or 24th of August, we should have one more webinar like this. It's no, players with a very clear picture after studying what is possible. Sure. And how do we take this forward? So for today, I will close here. I appreciate the initiative of the IWI. It's a grossly underutilized national asset. And I'm a very strong votary that this is something is a national resource being listed. And we get, you know, you write 100 letters to me about how Petropol and Binapol is a problem. Why don't we use this? And I wish in today's discussion, we could have had somebody from the our ambassador in Bangladesh maybe. But next time, Rajgopal, what you do is you get a letter written from my side, and we should have the our ambassador in Bangladesh also.
Yes, sir.
Once we meet once a month later. So that, you know, from their side, from her side, from Bangladesh perspective, she can give a complete picture of what is happening. And while you are working on this report and this possibility, talk to the Indian authorities in Bangladesh, the embassy. So that it's not just our side, we also see what are the problems on the Bangladesh side. And I'm sure IWI also would know what are the problems on the other side. So suppose I actually take a ship, which is, let's say, a yarn-loaded ship from here to which are the ports which are closest to the manufacturing hubs. Where do I offload? What are the problems? Where is the storage issues? What are the transportation issues on that side? How do I offload and transship into my trucks and take it to my factory? All those issues need to be sorted out. Customs, I'm sure he's part of the customs commissioner is part of this meeting. So let's move ahead like this and look forward to very seriously working with the Indian Waterways Authority. Thank you very much for having me here. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for laying out a framework of action and in 1 month's time. And also, we will surely do that, sir, and we will work towards creating this, trying to popularize this platform and identify all the bottlenecks and what is required to be done to take it forward. In fact, just as a point of note, sir, I had contacted Dr. Pramesh Basal of the High Commission, sir, in Bangladesh, but they were busy with some container moving or into Chittagong port today. They were busy receiving some ship. But then we will surely follow up. In the next meeting, we will get a letter written from you and get the our ambassador to High Commissioner to join in, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Now, may I request Mr. Rajesh Jindal, sir, Commissioner of Customs, Calcutta, sir. He has been very actively engaged with some of our members, but I had occasion to speak to him also. Mr. Jindal, please.
Yes. Good morning, Dr. Rajgopal. Chair, Secretary of Textile. Dr. Amita Prasad, Chairperson, Inland Waterways Authority. Dr. Srinivasan, Chairman, TexProSil. And I thank TexProSil to give me an opportunity to interact with the trade, which was my earnest desire. I say I joined this place in December, in the month of January. When I visited Petrapol, I found that the Petrapol road route is too much congested. Despite our best efforts, we were not able to clear the cargo in the same day. Despite our repeated discussions with the our counterpart in the Benapole Customs, so immediately the idea came to me that simultaneously we have to start rail route also and the waterway route also. That is the only solution. And the COVID times have given us a very good opportunity. And today we are on a platform that we are now initiating or pilot projects on the waterways route. Now, coming directly to the point, I will say in the last 6 months, sponge iron, quartz powder, hot and hot rolled non-alloy steels, sponge iron lumps, and WH beam. These are the new commodities which have been exported through the waterways to Bangladesh. Now, recently, new pilot consignment went by container. For the first time in the history, the goods were exported by containers to Bangladesh. The difference was that the containers this time were stuffed in the factory by the exporter himself. The containers moved under the seal, and at the port of export, Haldia, only seal check was done by the customs. Directly, the containers were loaded onto the barges. And now, more opportunity which we have provided is that now the documentation is to be done at land customs station. We call it TT shed. So customs TT shed is now fully computerized, means you can file the documents sitting from your office. You need not visit TT shed, and the let export and all everything you will get by email. Let export order, out of charge, everything will be sent to you by email. So if in the pilot consignment, I found that despite our trying very hard, the total time taken by the barge containing loaded with the containers was 12 days against the actual sailing time of 7 days. Means 5 days extra it took in the pilot run. And our emphasis will from the customs will be to reduce this 5 days time. Means that total transit time should be, we should reduce to the 7 days. And hopefully, I am sure that in the next consignment, but whenever the barges leave, we will be able to reduce to straight away 8 days. So this will be a lot of saving in terms of time, and time is cost. It will be cost saving for you also. And from our side, many queries are coming that what items I can export, what item, whether I can export LCL, less container load, whether I can send by container or should I send by bulk also. I want to clarify that since January, when we have shifted to EDI on the TT shed, there is no restriction. This, the software which is being run at TT shed is the same, which is operational at any custom station or at any seaport. Whatever items are allowed at Petrapol, the same are allowed at TT shed. And same facilities in Petrapol also, you can do the remote filing of documents. Here also you can do the remote filing of documents. And now recently I discussed with Mr. Shukla, member IWAI. He is told that they want to start the containerized movement from GR Jetty. GR Jetty is a place, let me first elaborate that TT shed is the place where documents are filed. Actual loading is done at another 10 points of loading. These 10 points of loadings are, one is TT shed, Bandel, Kolaghat, Bhajbhaj jetty, one J- Jetty 2, Jetty 3, Jetty 4, GR Jetty, VSIN Jetty, and Haldia Docks. It means that for these 10 points of loading, you can choose to load the goods into the barge or vessel at your convenience. And TT Shed, though, is a little far from these places, but you need not visit TT Shed. Sitting at a remote location, you can submit the documents. Like, it is just like you can book the airline ticket or railway ticket sitting at your home. Same is that with the documentation with the customs. And once whatever is help or hand holding or assurances are required from my side, I can say that you can straight away talk to me, and my staff is always available to help you. And if there is any issue, you can raise the issue with Mr. Shukla. We are also in touch regularly. Whenever he raises this any issue with me, we are able to solve very soon, that I can assure you. And thanks again.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your comments, and we look forward to for interacting with you more closely. Now, may I request Shashi Bhushan ji to make his presentation, sir, on the facilities being offered by Inland Waterways. Shashi Bhushan ji. Can you start, Mr. Shashi Bhushan? Can you unmute, Mr. Shashi Bhushan? Please unmute. Mr. Shashi Bhushan, can you unmute, please? Please unmute, Mr. Bhushan. Mr. Shukla, kindly unmute.
Now, are you able to hear me?
Now kindly unmute, sir, and then start, sir. Now it's all right. You can hear you now.
Okay, so respected Chairperson IWAI, respected Secretary C. Ravi Kapoor Sahab, Mr. Jindal, Commissioner Customs, and all the stalwarts of industry. I'm making a brief presentation on basically on the trade with Bangladesh through inland waterways routes. So we all are aware about the cost benefits and environment benefits of inland waterways. I will go through the challenges, basically why the things are not moving despite of so much of advantage, and what opportunity we are going to offer on this route. So inland waterways, we have developed a lot of infrastructure on NW1 and Indo-Bangladesh coastal route that includes fairway development, so providing the water routes. We have also provided navigational aids. Are having night navigation. We have provided river information system. We have also provided a lot of digital positioning system and digital portals where we are providing all the information, mostly on real-time basis also. And we have developed few multimodal terminals. One terminal is coming very soon in Haldia, which is on the IBP route. Other than this, we have created navigational logs. We have created vessel operation systems. And we are providing pilot system also on this route for the ease of voyage. This is the map of Indo-Bangladesh protocol route. And as Madam Chairperson has also explained regarding the Eastern Grid. So this waterway system provides connectivity with the UP, Bihar, West Bengal side in the north part of India, with the Bangladesh, and then with the northeastern part of India. And it also connects with the coastal route. So this particular grid, which is being provided by inland water system, can be very utilized by the trade. Right now, we are not moving textile on IBP route, but we are moving not many other commodities. Approximately 600 to 700 vessels are moving in this route, Indo-Bangladesh protocol route, and around 4,000 voyages took place. This figure is of last year. Last to last year, around 4,000 voyages have taken place last year. And there is a traffic of 3.5 million tons. And in this route, on 20th May, one significant agreement has been signed between India and Bangladesh, in which 13 ports of call, loading and unloading point, as Secretary Sir has mentioned, have been agreed between India and Bangladesh. So 13 ports of call in India and 13 ports of call in Bangladesh. And most of these ports of call are having the handling facilities. I have been receiving requests for loading at GRJT. So I just wanted to share with you all that in Kolkata, we have GRJT, which is being operated by one Bangladeshi company, who have also one terminal in Bangladesh operated by the same company, and they are part of this webinar. So we have all the facilities for handling container and bulk and break bulk at GRJT, which is IWIJ. Likewise, we have one multimodal terminal at Haldia, which is going to be ready by January. That will also have all the state-of-art cargo handling facilities. Kolkata port at NS Dock has all the facilities for loading of containers and bulk and break bulk. That is also part of Indo-Bangladesh protocol too. Likewise, Haldia Dock Complex also has all these facilities. So container loading facilities are available at four terminals on our side. Likewise, in Bangladesh, Pangaon has been included as a port of call, which is having a elaborate facilities, custom facilities also, and terminal handling facilities also, and they can handle containers. Likewise, Mukhtarpur in SAPL, which is also managed by our GRJT operator, they also have container handling facilities, and both of these locations are very close to Dhaka. They are in the city itself. So these OD pairs can be utilized by the textile industry for transport. As Commissioner Customs has already told that even LCL is allowed, and there is no additional procedural requirements what we are having in land custom stations. Almost same requirements are here also. And customs has come out with lot many digital initiatives, so you need not to visit physically to the various places, and the clearance can be obtained online. As we have done one first containerized movement, as Mr. Jindal has also mentioned, in this the voyage time was 7 days, and we have identified certain procedural time lags, which we have shared with customs also, and we are sharing with immigration also and other agencies, and we are trying to curtail it down so that this voyage of 7 days, which takes place actually, should only be the time which is taking place. So procedural time will be reduced. Apart from these 7 days, we are also working on the night navigation facilities, which are going to come in place, and these we are strengthening RIS, etc. And we have been discussing with the exporter that how can we reduce this time further from 7 days to 4.5 days. So that is one that maybe in future we'll be able to reduce from 7 days to 4.5 days with the night navigation facilities and better pilotage, etc. And to the custom procedure, I think most of you are aware, Commissioner Customs have also explained that this is the same, almost similar procedure what we have in LCS. The only thing is by filing of shipping bill takes place at DTC, and which can be done online. And then after cross-border certificate is given at Hemnagar, which is the border of India and Bangladesh. And now we are trying to further streamline it. And these are certain digital initiatives which IWI has taken, in which we are providing the information relating to assets, relating to LED availability, and relating to pilotage, etc., on our e-portal. So when you are planning your voyage, you can see the availability of depth, etc. As Madam Chairperson has also explained, on this route, when we are going only from Kolkata to Bangladesh, there is no problem of depth, because most of the region is tidal, and a vessel of 3 to 3.5 meter draft can easily go, which can carry 2,000 ton or 1,500 ton. This is we have also created this technology, which is going to be uploaded on our website. So I just thought I will refer that we are taking, and Focal is a forum where shippers and cargo owners, they can basically, it is an aggregation portal where you can interact with each other, where the vessel operators are also registered and cargo owners are also. So this is on our website, which is going to be very soon. Some of them are already active and some of them will be active. So this is what I thought I will present. Apart from this, I will just like to inform that you can also take cargo to Northeast through inland waterways with a draft of 2.5 meter, which is available uniformly. And Bhutan also can be can also go through inland waterways. And India and Bangladesh have a coastal shipping agreement. In the coastal shipping agreement, the vessels can come through our eastern coast. Almost all the coasts are port of call, and they can come to Haldia. There can be an aggregation, or they can be transit to the smaller barges, and from there it can take into Northeast or to Bangladesh. So if something is being exported from Coimbatore, it can be loaded at Chennai, or it can be loaded at from there it can come to Dhaka through only through waterways. That is, that possibility is also there. So thank you. This was my brief presentation, and then after if some question is there, we'll be happy to reply. Thank you so much. I think you have not unmuted, Mr. Rajbhar.
May I add something along with Shashi?
Yes, madam.
Yeah, I just like to add one or two things. One, that we have excellent relationship with our counterpart in Bangladesh, which they really take care of all our requests, and they are also a very good system of pilotage and other things. So in the navigation side, we do not have any problem. Number two, that the committee which Secretary Textile has suggested, I think that is a very good suggestion. And from our side, member traffic, along with our regional officer of Kolkata and one or two people who are available in Kolkata, will be participating in that. And we should really look into this problem along with the pilot movement. We have some private logistic people whom we have hired some of the vessels. I'm sure they can come forward and we can take up this commodity. So let us not wait further and mull over a lot of issues. Let us deep dive into this and see what are the problems head on. So this is what I just wanted to add with what my member made a presentation on. Thank you.
Sure, ma'am. Thank you very much. We will take that forward. May I? We also have from the Adani Logistic Limited, madam, they wanted to make a presentation about the containerized cargo. So Mr. Prashant Kumar is there. Mr. Anil Kishore Singh, if you're there, a few words from you. Then Mr. Prashant Kumar, please.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much for the opportunity, Dr. Rajgopal. I am very much there. This is Anil Kishore Singh, CEO, Adani Logistics Inland Waterways Vertical. I will start by thanking the Inland Waterways Authority, Madam Prasad, Mr. Shukla, for giving us and recommending us for this opportunity to speak to your members over here. I think this is the best possible example of public-private partnership. We are the company who have done the pilot voyage, so-called. We don't really want to call it a pilot voyage because we want to make it into a regular run. Mr. Jindal has already mentioned that the initial voyage took 12 days. You will be glad to know that after the completion of the voyage, the vessel is already reaching Kolkata on its return leg. So the round voyage is being completed now, and we are ready for the next load. And because we are ready for the next load, we had requested for this opportunity to sensitize your members about the possibility, very real possibilities of inland waterways, which is what Prashant, my colleague, will take you through now. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Yes, Mr. Prashant. Yeah, go ahead, Mr. Prashant.
Yes, sir. I'm just trying to open a presentation, a short, brief presentation on it. I hope it is seen there, sir.
You can see that. Yes.
Okay, sir. So this is. Presentation is about the pilot voyage which we have completed. So we have identified that there is an opportunity that $2.7 billion worth of goods are right now being exported and imported via land border at Petropol. And this is all primarily through road. So this is the traffic which we see has a huge potential to shift to inland waterways because of the delays which are faced by everyone in the industry. and has been identified by the authorities also that there are problems which requires alternative modes of transportation. So just to give you a broad understanding of the waterways, this is an entire picture of National Waterway 1, the Indo-Bangladesh Protocol route, as well as the National Waterway 2. This Varanasi to Haldia section is National Waterway 1. From Haldia to India border, it is National Waterway 87. And from India border to further India border up to Assam, it is Indo-Bangladesh Protocol route. This is not the only route. There are a few other branches also. I am just showing the connectivity from Haldia to Assam and Haldia to Pangaon. And post this protocol route, this is National Waterway 2 from Dhubri up to Dibrugarh on Brahmaputra. Like mentioned in the presentation by Mr. Shukla, that these are the port of call, so I'll not get into it. This is a broad distances for better understanding, and the right-hand side, these are the routes that we follow. So when we start from Haldia, we actually follow river and canal route via the Sundarbans. We reach a Hemnagar custom border, which is on the Indian side of the custom checkpoint. Then we cross, there is a Sheikh Beria custom point where we do customs and immigration. And via Mongla Chandpur, we actually reach Narayanganj, or you can say Pangaon. The total distance from Calcutta is approximately 735 kilometers on waterway. And if we go by Haldia, it would be around 625 to 630 kilometers. This is a typical vessel that we utilized for our pilot movement. This is a 64 container vessel, two stack height, and we can easily transport at around 2.5 to 2.6 meter with a load of around 1400 to 1500 metric tons. And when fully loaded, it would be approximately 1800 tons when all the containers are fully loaded. This is a broad description of the maiden voyage that we completed. Though the capacity is 64 TEUs, but because of certain delays, we only carried around 45 TEUs. These are bagged sponge iron, around 1250 metric tons. The vessel was flagged off on 30th of June, but as Jesus has said, that there were a few delays due to the issues with the EDI system. And then we actually sailed on 5th of July, early morning, and reached on 12th of July at Pangaon. We discharged all the containers within 6 hours once we get the berthing position. And post-discharge, immediately our vessel has sailed back for India. So if you look at the transaction timeline, the transaction timelines are very short. In 4 hours, we can actually discharge 64 containers. And vessel is free to go back. And similarly for the loading part, the vessels are loaded within 4 to 5 hours when the consignment is ready to be loaded. There are some problems that we faced, but we received a lot of support from Jindal sir and his office in getting it rectified. All the customs related issues, basically between the land custom station at TT shed and loading point in Haldia dock, have been resolved. The factory sealing acceptance has been resolved. The issues related to let export order has been resolved. So right now we don't see any custom related problem. Only we see that we can create much more efficiencies to cut down the timeline. These are few pictures for the vessel which is sailing through the Sundarbans. This is a description of the timelines that we have achieved in the entire maiden voyage. Though we completed it in 12 days, but the actual sailing time was 7 days. This will further illustrate on where we faced, how much delays, and what was the reason for it. But the actual picture is this one, which we would like to achieve in the future voyages, which is once departed from Haldia or Calcutta, we'll try to reach Pangaon in Narayanganj or in Dhaka in 7 days. There are a few activities before loading. There are a few activities after loading. That all depends upon what are the scope of work, like whether we are factory sealing or we are bringing the consignment to a CFS, and then from CFS we are moving it to terminal. So all the activities before that is dependent completely on the consignment. But once loaded, within 7 days, we are able to reach Dhaka. A turnaround time of 20 days is what we are achieving, and we may achieve 22 days for Calcutta. This is a typical service offering. Right now we have on inland waterways, so we can receive the goods at a CFS in Calcutta or Haldia, post packaging of the stuffing and packaging of the goods in a container. We will get it sealed and custom cleared at a CFS and then transfer it to a loading port. Yes, and we can also accept a factory stuffed container, which will be cleared directly by our CHA at PT Shed. Once the goods move from CFS to the port, we will facilitate in all port related paperwork. We will facilitate with all the paperwork which is required for loading of the container, then the safe transportation and the terminal discharging in Dhaka. And then we will carry out all the C&F related work in Dhaka to actually clear the containers from the customs there. The only responsibility which lies with the consignee is to pay for the documentation charges and the storage charges at the terminal in Dhaka and take the delivery. At Haldia, the only responsibility with the shipper is to deliver the cargo at this year. I have already the documents which are required in order to carry out the services. These are very simple documents which are generally being used in the shipping industry, which is like copy of a letter of credit, performa invoice, country of origin certificate, the packing list, the letter of undertaking, bank details with AD codes, importer and exporter code. So these are the generic requirements. So there is no drastic difference in the documentation requirement when we are actually transporting the goods via inland waterways. These are broad commercials that we have worked out. This will help, and we can circulate this presentation for better understanding of everyone who is in this webinar. Yes, and there is what we have achieved right now. There is a movement which are taking place via Chittagong to Dhaka, as well as via rail to Benapole, Petrobol, water, and further a road movement to Dhaka. So if we compare the end-to-end door-to-door cost, then certainly this service is approximately 20% cheaper as compared to road and coastal movement. This was a broad presentation from our end.
Rajgopal, I'd like to, you know, just add a couple of things. You know, today from Bangladesh, we have almost $500 million import of ready-made garments.
Yes, sir.
They are coming back from Bangladesh to India. Now, that is all these vessels which are going there to easily tie up with our, and I'm sure Rahul Mehta is listening to me. These ready-mades which are coming from Bangladesh can also come in these vessels which are coming back. I also saw typing it out that jute. Yes, jute is another big area which we can tie. And I'm sure I forgot today to tell our trade advisors that we should have had the jute people also inside. And can you switch off the mic?
Invited them.
Yeah. So. Jute bodies also need to be associated. IJMA is there. Indian Jute Manufacturers Association is there. Should also be associated with this group. And so jute, finished good from Bangladesh, textile. I'm just talking about textile. Textile is moving in a big way. We can look at that also when we talk about establishing a river route for this. That just these 2 points. Siddharth, you can continue.
We come now to the Q&A section, sir. With your permission, sir, we have a few of our meeting EPC chairmen with us, sir. We'll invite them to give their short comments. So may I begin with Mr. Saraf, sir, president of FIO, and FIO is quite active in that region, in the Petrapol issues they have been taking up. Saraf, sir?
Sir, Siddharth, thanks a lot for giving me this opportunity. Secretary sir, madam, you know, it is primarily this audience is mostly textile based, but actually it is a lot of other cargoes which are facing difficulty in shipment to Bangladesh, particularly agro commodities. We had a serious issue of shipping onions from Maharashtra to Bangladesh, and finally we got the railways to take the rake. Sir, all over the world, inland waterways are very well established. US is using the Mississippi system, Europe is using Rhine and Danube both very well. We are already years and years behind. It's an excellent initiative by the government to establish the Inland Waterway Authority, and Madam is very dynamic, and I am very sure. And we are in PO, we are working closely with IWAI, and I am sure that we will succeed. What I would suggest is, at the moment, most important thing is to create the facilities for seamless export. For example, if I am shipping a container from Mumbai, I should be able to get a through BL from Mumbai to maybe Pangaon or Chatgaon or wherever. So that is how I think it has to go. 1 minute, sir. Okay. So we need to create facilities at the moment more than anything else. I think this will at least add 50% addition to our bilateral trade on both ways. So, sir, I think we in FIO would be very happy to support any initiative in this direction. I'm very happy that Secretary wanted to broad-base this, but maybe we can even call some commodity exporters, leaders of commodity exporters into the group. Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you. May I request Dr. Shakti Ved, sir, Chairman APC, sir, would you like to come in? Dr. Shakti Ved, please.
Thank you for giving me the opportunity. I thank our honorable respected secretary and madam for creating this inland waterway in big way. Definitely, it will help textile industry a lot. And the beginning is good. I think our respected secretary has fixed the date for the next month. So by the time, I think things will be more smoothly. I once again thank the government for doing this on apparel export promotion culture on behalf of them. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. May I request Mr. Ronak Rugani, sir, Chairman SRTPC. They also have a lot of shipments in Bangladesh. Mr. Rugani, sir. Mr. Rugani, unmute and come, please.
Yes, yes. Namaskar, sir. Namaskar to everyone. Well, this is again, like, you know, a very proactive measure by our secretary. We've been seeing a lot of initiatives being taken. Also, a great presentation by the, Waterways Authority of India. With Bangladesh, this is, you know, if this really works well and everything is streamlined, it will work well for everyone, because 1/4 of our borders with Bangladesh are riverine. So we'll be looking forward to it, and once this moves ahead, we'll be able in a better position to interact. Currently, the only issues that have been coming, and you know, we have been actually writing to the secretary daily for the issues between the Petropol border and the Benapol borders, etc. So this will really help, and plus recently the railways has also made movements by rail of Indian commodities to Bangladesh, which has been fairly successful. So once these logistical issues are sorted, are moving in the right direction, and it will be very great. Rest of the other points have been very well covered by Dr. Srinivas also, Dr. Shaktivel also, Saraf Saab also. So I don't have anything much more to add. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Now may I request Mr. Rahul Mehta, sir, the chief mentor of CMAI. Rahul, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Secretary Saab and Madam, for this opportunity. I have just two points to make. Sir, you've been talking about the movement of finished goods. You are well aware, Secretary Saab, about the issues involved. But since you mentioned that you are likely to be entering into a textile MOU, I would just like to draw your attention to our problems of the excessive duties in Bangladesh for exports of Indian garments. And I think if we can resolve that, I think there can be a lot of increase in the shipments and the exports to Bangladesh of finished garments, especially from the ethnic wear brand. If you recall, sir, we had discussed about the possibility of evolving separate HS codes, etc. So I just thought I would draw your attention to that. And secondly, a point addressed to the waterways authorities. Typically, garment exports, especially to a country like Bangladesh, would not be in full container loads. So is there adequate provision for part container consignments also? Or for that, we would have to go to the usual road transport and rail transport. That is a query that I had. Thank you.
Thank you, Rahul Bhai. Would you like to respond to that, Shashi Bhushan ji? Yes, please.
Yes, sir. Regarding the consignment for LCL, we have a facility of LCL container handling available in India as well as in Dhaka. So let's say if two, three consignees can come together, right, form a container, we can move it. There's no issue. Yeah.
Thank you very much. Sit down.
Yes. Excuse me, if I'm being allowed to speak on this, I'm Sagar from SAPL. We're, as Member Traffic said, we are the port operator. We're running a port facility in GRGT as well as in SAPL Mukhtarpur Terminal. I just like to add one thing. Moving LCL cargo from Calcutta will not be challenging. The challenge is at the Bangladesh side, because our primary target area should be to reach somewhere near to Dhaka or Narayanganj, where you have all these, you know, textile factories. Now, the nearest facility is Pangaon, and as well as our terminal, which is Mukhtarpur. And in these two terminals, LCL cargo acceptance is not allowed by the customs as of now. So this has not been approved. So discharge of LCL cargo is not allowed so far. While we are trying for an approval, but this has not been received as so far. So like, so there will be a difficulty of discharging LCL containers at Pangaon and as well as in Mukhtarpur terminal.
Thank you very much, sir, for the clarifications. I think there's a lot to be discussed, and I'm sure there's a lot of other questions. We have a couple of them as well here. Before we move to the actual question, one or two more comments, sir. Now, may I request CCI Chairman, Mr. P.K. Agarwal, is also with us. Agarwal, sir. Agarwal, sir, unmute current. All right.
Good morning, Chairperson, Madam, Mr. Chair, Secretary, sir, Chairman of the various councils, custom authorities. As you know, cotton production in Bangladesh is only 2 lakh, whereas their consumption is 100 lakhs. So thus, there is a good potential for export of cotton to Bangladesh. I talked recently to Ms. Reeva Ganguly-ji, who is the High Commissioner of India in Bangladesh. She was very positive to extend all cooperation to CCI. And I appreciate Secretary also. If this task can be taken government to government basis, as was decided in the recent meeting in February, it will be great help to CCI, because we have an adequate stock to export, and it will be an alternative channel for us also to maximize the revenue and to reduce the MSP losses. Besides this, I am thankful to the custom authorities who have introduced this in-house custom. In-house stuffing at factory. Besides this, LEO is also online. This will certainly help in exporting cotton. I am really thankful to them. Presently, we can export cotton to Bangladesh through road also, as well as waterways. Chittagong is the best port for Bangladesh mills. We can explore these possibilities, as Secretary Sir has suggested, to form a group. I think that group will definitely give good recommendations which can be considered by the government. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Agarwalji. Thank you very much. Now, may I request, we have from the jute sector, Rishi Jalan is there from Yukon. He imports jute from Bangladesh. Secretary Sir was mentioning, Jalan Sir, can you come in, sir?
Yeah, and good afternoon. I am representing, can you hear me, please?
Yeah, yes, please.
Yeah, I'm representing Jute Product Development and Export Promotion Council. Our members are importing jute goods from Bangladesh on a regular basis. Till now, the import is happening only from the land port, and as discussed, we'll be more than happy to explore the possibility of importing from seaport also. So this is a welcoming move, and whatever input is required from our side, we'll be more than happy to provide the same. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. The therefore, container going from here can come back with the jute goods, as the secretary was pointing out. We can balance the trade, sir. That's very good, sir. Now, we've got two or three practitioners in the trade who have really suffered at the Petropole border and have been raising issues. May I request Mr. Ashish Bagrodia, sir, of Winsome Textiles, and he has also put a question on the chat box, and he has some specific questions. Ashish ji, can you unmute and come? Ashish ji? Mr. Ashish Bagrodia?
I think he doesn't seem to be asked.
There are one or two questions. He's asked, if I may read them out to the chat box, is there a fixed schedule of barge movement from various loading points to Bangladesh? That's one question, sir. Maybe Prashant can answer, or Shashi Bhushan ji. Is there a fixed schedule of barge movement from various loading points?
See, right now, there is no fixed schedule, sir, in this stage. So basically, it's a barge operator and the skipper, they will have to contact each other.
Okay, sir. Fine, thank you. Therefore, on containerized movement from factory to Bangladesh, now Mr. Ashish Bagrodia of Winsome Textiles, which is located in Baddi in Himachal Pradesh, where will we get the containers to come to our factory for factory stuffing? I don't know.
I'm Sagar once again from SAPL.
Yeah, please.
With Adani, we are trying to start a fixed schedule. We are doing our pay, but the cargo availability and all is a challenge. But we are trying to have a fortnightly sailing as of now. And the empty containers are available in our facility, which is in GRJT. And the staffing facility is also available in GRJT. So, the advantage that I like to add here is if we are using the river route, and rather than going into port, which is like in Calcutta port or in Haldia, you are dependent on a lock gate system. So while we are on the bank of the river, so once the unloading is completed, you can sail easily depending on the tide schedule. And also, when you are going to Narayanganj, or you are going very near to the Dhaka, so Narayanganj and Dhaka is basically where the concentration of all the textile cargo. So if you are discharging, you are reaching very far to your last mile point. So, and from there, Dhaka is about 3-4 hours journey at night. So you are avoiding the land congestion. So that is one of the advantages that of using the river route.
Fine, Mr. Sagar, I think we'll get we'll have a discussion offline also to see, because you raised a number of issues and solutions you are providing.
Sure.
So we'll take it offline as well. Now there's one more question, sir. From Mr. Brijaratan Pandya. Which shipping lines has given approvals? Mr. Pandya, are you there? He has put a question on the chat. Mr. Pandya? I think he's not there. Maybe his question is there. Maybe we can take a look at that. Rishi Jalan said whether these facilities will be available for import of finished jute goods, also from Bangladesh. That's one question. These jute goods are also allowed, sir, in the return journey, imported?
Yeah, all commodities are allowed on the river route. Something can be imported or exported to Bangladesh.
Okay. Mr. Brajrat Pandya, are you there? We can take forward your question. I want two more observations, sir. We have got Mr. Aditya Narya, is a group head from Arvind Limited, sir. And we also have Mr. Dheeraj Banka, who is the Vice President of Satluj Textiles. I mean, both of them have been using the Petropole border and had a lot of issues with stuck-up consignment. So may I request Mr. Aditya Narya to say a few words?
Sure. Thank you so much. Good afternoon, everyone.
What we have been talking to Adani's for the last 1.5-2 months, and we are very, very keen to make sure that this route of using river and inland waterways is actually successful. Two quick points on this. If you look at the overall transit time, right now is really high as compared to road transport. Today we are all discussing this because there is a problem at the Benapole and Petrapole border. But for inland waterways to actually become successful, there are two elements which have to be taken care of. And one is the transit time, which right now is high, and we will have to see how we can reduce this time, whether it is about loading, unloading, whether it is customs clearance, or it is even movement from factories which are on the western side of India to eastern borders. The second part is the cost of logistics at the moment. And what we also understand from the Adani team is that right now the bigger challenge is return cargo. And as Shri Ravi Kapoorji mentioned, it will be very important to have return cargo for all these, for river movement, so that the overall cost for both exporters and importers can come down. For us, these two points are something which are very critical. Having said that, we will be working back with them very closely to start this proof of concept. And some of the consignments we are internally discussing how we can move through this river route. So looking forward, very excited, and our group will definitely support this. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Narya. I think as we mentioned, we should actively take part in the pilot projects which they are trying to develop, and we should give our full cooperation and see the bottlenecks, as the secretary mentioned, that we need to identify and overcome them. Anyway, thank you very much for your inputs. May I now request Mr. Dheeraj Banka, if he is there. Would you like to say a few words, Mr. Banka? Satluj Textiles? Unmute and come, please. Mr. Dheeraj Banka? I think he doesn't seem to be there. Anyway, sir, these were some of the questions which had been given. And all the other participants, if you have any questions, kindly email it to us. We will take it up with the authorities, who have been more than trying to come forward to solve the issues. And
Siddharth, can I just make one point, please?
Yes, this. Who's this, please?
Rahul here. Rahul Mehta.
Yes, please. Rahul, yeah, please.
I was just requesting if the waterways authorities can make a apple-to-apple comparison between road transport, rail transport, and waterway transport in terms of the cost and in terms of the time taken. I think these are the two most essential elements to decide on a logistic system. So if y'all can make in your presentation or a separate presentation an apple to apple comparison of per kilo or per ton or whatever is the appropriate measure, I think it will help the various trade associations and councils gathered here to sell the concept to its members.
Sure, sir. Very good idea, sir. I think they've already done an exercise in the PPT, but I think they need to get it closer and have a very close look at it. As Rahul Bhai, you're mentioning apple to apple and point to point, so that all it's a threadbare comparison and the trade can take a call on what is the most cost effective way of transporting. So Shashi ji, we will work with you on that and take it forward, sir. Moon, I think anybody else would like to have a comment or a question? I think we are generally through with the presentation as well as the formal question. If there are many other questions which can be taken offline, sir, and all of us kindly write to us, we will take it up with the authorities, who are very open to suggestions and are looking to develop this entire waterway, and we all should cooperate with them. And I think it's been a great initiative. May I then request 1 minute. Would you like to add something, sir? Chairman Texposil, sir?
I just want to thank all the it's been very active participation. There seems to be a lot of potential. Very good suggestions have come forward. So I would suggest that we consolidate all the data and proceed. But as Secretary has pointed out, there's very good potential here, and we should take both, for trade in both directions. Thank you.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Request. Thank you very much, sir. Can I request our Vice Chairman, Mr. Manoj Patodia, to propose a word of thanks, sir. Mr. Manoj Patodia.
Yeah, thank you, Siddharthji. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's my proud privilege to propose the vote of thanks towards the conclusion of this webinar on Inland Waterway Transport Corridor for Textile Exports to Bangladesh. Friends, many of our members have been reporting challenges while trading with neighboring Bangladesh. Hence, at the instance of the Ministry of Textiles, Government of India, it was decided to organize this webinar in association with Inland Waterways Authority of India. We are very grateful to Sri Ravi Kapoorji, Secretary, Ministry of Textiles, for being the motivating force behind today's webinar, and thank the Ministry for always being there to guide us in these critical times. And sir, we assure you that we will take this opportunity to our textile members and to take advantage of this. We also thank Dr. Amita Prasad, Chairperson of Inland Waterways Authority of India, for introducing to all of us the excellent work undertaken by IWAI in developing alternative modes of transport, especially the waterways. Our thanks are also due to Sri Rajesh Jindal, Commissioner of Customs Preventive at Kolkata, West Bengal, who has been sensitive to the logistics issues in the region and has been actively interacting with the trade and industry in finding solution. Friends, our wholehearted thanks to the team from Indian Waterways Authority of India, including Sri Shashi Bhushan Shukla, Member Traffic and Logistics, for his presentation, which will guide us in the choice of National Waterway Transport System as an added alternative for the Indo-Bangladesh trade, textile trade. We also thank the other colleagues at IWAI, including Sri A.K. Bansal, Director Traffic and Logistics, Sri L.K. Rajak, Director IWAI Kolkata, and Sri Sagar Kastogi, Summit Alliance Port East Gateway India Private Limited, Kolkata, who are present in today's webinar. I also like to thank Sri P.K. Agarwalji, Chairman of Cotton Corporation of India, and the team from Adani, led by the CEO, for the presentation. We also are indebted to our senior colleagues from the industry and representatives of the APEX Export Promotion Council, textile associates present today, including Sri Sharad Sarabji, President FIO, Dr. Shakti Velji, Chairman AEPC, Sri Rorak Rugani, Chairman SRTPC, Sri Rahul Mehtaji, Chief Mentor CMAI, Sri Neil Kankani, Chairman JPDEPC, who have highlighted the various bottlenecks being faced with the transportation of goods to Bangladesh. We are also grateful to the representatives of the media for offering coverage of today's event in the renowned publication. Finally, thank you one and all for attending today's webinar. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, sir. We now come to the conclusion, sir. With your permission, Secretary, sir, is anything would you like to...
Just, as decided, we should meet on 22nd, 23rd of August.
Yes, sir.
Report. All the stakeholders who have shown interest should be represented in the committee. Please keep in touch with Madam, has just mentioned somebody. From her side, from her team, two people. Take everybody on board. Talk it out in the next 3 weeks, 4 weeks. Talk it out completely. And I have a small roadmap on how we can help the industry to migrate from the problems of Beenapol and Petropol into this. And you know, a very important point mentioned by, I think, somebody towards the end, Mr. Mehta, that you know, if I have to start from the western side, from Bombay or Chennai or ports from that side, what is my end-to-end cost? So if Coimbatore is sending some finished products, or if it is cotton being sent from Maharashtra or say Gujarat, then what is my end-to-end apple-to-apple comparison cost? I think we'll request the NHAI, IWAI to give us a comparative cost, so that the whole thing, you know, we can share it with the industry. Let's be open. It's just, I'm absolutely sure it's all about one, that IWAI is a very distinct body. Nobody knows about it. So I think that's a very good initiative of the chairperson. Let's bring them towards the industry. And secondly, that this is a very economical route. I think this is to be established to the industry. Should prepare a paper on that line, and then we can work on this. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your inspiring words. We'll take it forward, sir, as you mentioned. And by 22nd, 23rd August, we'll come out and have another one, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you to Madam Chairperson also, and all the other participants. Thank you, sir, for making it.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.